We've got the insanely popular 2021 Lexus RX350 in Blackline trim. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Makse, racing driver, and on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, why are we driving this Lexus RX? Well, there's a couple of reasons. One, it is very popular, and I haven't driven one in a long time. Secondly, it's made in Canada, and I am Canadian after all, and we are here in Canada at the moment, so I'm very interested to see what a Canadian-made luxury crossover is like these days. So join me as we have a look at this RX in a little more depth. This is the non-hybrid RX, of course, so it's got the naturally aspirated 3.5 liter V6, and because we are in Canada, it is all-wheel drive only. That 3.5 liter V6 makes 295 horsepower at 6,300 RPM and 267 pounds of torque at 4,700 RPM, and it's very much a naturally aspirated V6 character. Transmission is an 8-speed automatic, and because, again, this is Canada, it is all-wheel drive. Chassis is a unibody, McPherson struts up front, double wishbones rear, with the regular F-Sport suspension calibration. This one does not have the adaptive dampers. Brakes are 12.9 inch rotors up front with two piston calipers and 13.3 inch rotors in the back with single piston caliper. Steering is electric, of course, because this is the Blackline. It's got 20 inch black wheels with 235 55 20 all season tires. We are in winter mode, so we are on some winter tires right now. Curb weight is just under 4,400 pounds, and in some configurations, you can tow 3,500 pounds, just not in this specification. It's that time in the episode four, how to spec your Lexus RX. Base price in the United States is $45,070, and that is for a front-wheel drive RX in pretty basic trim. Here in Canada, the base price is $56,560, and that, of course, is for all-wheel drive, and that's the only way we get them in Canada. In the US, all-wheel drive adds $1,400 to the price of any RX. This is the Blackline edition, which I mentioned, which gets some of the F-Sport stuff and a host of options and convenience features. What you're looking at is Grecian water paint, which you can't get in the US, and this new luxe black and white interior. With other options or trims, you can get the F-Sport handling package, which adds adaptive dampers, a recalibrated electric power steering system, and a Sport Plus drive mode. And I'd like to try that setup, actually. And apparently in the US, you can get a Zero Halliburton luggage set as well, which is pretty wild. As tested, this is about $50,635 US. Here in Canada, it's $65,000. Even. Now, how do you spec yours? Well, that is the question. There are so many configurations you can choose from, two or three row. This is the two row. You can also get this in hybrid. And as you guys know, you can get this in front wheel drive or all wheel drive in the United States, but in Canada, just all wheel drive only. So that is the question. Do you want hybrid? Do you need two rows? Do you need three rows? Do you need front wheel drive or do you need all wheel drive? Spec it at your pleasure. As you'd expect from Lexus, the seating position is just fine. Seats very comfortable and supportive, lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering column, so you can set yourself up appropriately, you can see all around, and you know, it just does all the right things. Like, you know, when you put the shifter in reverse and you're parking, well, that mirror turns inboard drop so you can see the curb, so you don't curb your wheels. Lots of fun little useful features like that, which I appreciate. Also, I do have to say, I mean, ergonomically, it's a little bizarre because the heated seat controls are here, ventilated seats in this model as well. But then the heated steering wheel button is way over here on the left. I don't know why that is ergonomically. It doesn't make sense to me. If I'm going to have the heated seats on, I'm probably going to have the steering wheel heated as well. And this is winter, of course, so I am using those functions. That said, what I love, and this is a good thing because on this channel, we know you put your hands at 9 and 3 on the steering wheel. And unlike some other vehicles, this heated steering wheel heats the wheel at 9 and 3 only. So up here, there's no heat. Down here, there's no heat. So if you're using the function, it's great because it encourages drivers to put their hands at 9 and 3 on the steering wheel where they should be. Lots of people complain about these screens that grow at the top of the dash. But what Lexus has done here is positioned it perfectly. It is not in the way at all, because there is a vast expanse of dashboard here, but the screen is not in the way at all, and it is very large and very clear. That said, I do have to talk about the infotainment system and this interface. I'm sure plenty of owners will say lots of positive things about it, and maybe it takes some getting used to, but I do not like this infotainment interface in any of the recent Lexuses I've driven. I'd rather have something simpler and more straightforward. I don't understand why they've done this, because there are plenty of other solutions out there. Of course, it is saved by Apple CarPlay, which works wonderfully, and on the big screen it works great, looks perfect. As this is the two-row RX, it is massively spacious. Up front, lots of storage, no worries there. Love the fold-out little sort of storage cubbies in the doors on both sides, that's great. Lots of room in that second row as well, and then plenty of space under the hatch. Again, makes sense why a lot of people buy these things, because it's just so easy to live with on a day-to-day basis. I'd say first and second level ergonomics are pretty good, very straightforward, pretty intuitive, but then it's once you get into that third level where things just don't make sense, and then of course it's compounded by this touchpad and everything else, the infotainment control, it just doesn't work for me in that regard. And you know, maybe some owners can get back to me on how they use it. I have just not found it as effective as other systems. In terms of performance, this is a relatively heavy mid-size crossover at, what, 4,400 pounds or so. And with the power that this 3.5 liter V6 makes, it's just adequate. Lexus says this will do 0 to 60 in under 8 seconds, and that seems about right. But this is... it really has no sporting intentions whatsoever, but that's not why people buy these. Yes, you can get that F-Sport handling package with the dampers and the recalibrated steering, but in this trim, there's nothing sporting about this. Handling is adequate. Braking is adequate. Braking is actually, I'd say, above average, and there's decent feel out of the brake pedal as well, which I like, and that is, of course, your first level of safety. So good brakes are always important, which Lexus does. But in terms of the way this handles, well, it's not sporting at all. It is very much tuned for ride comfort and overall just kind of chill driving. And again, that's probably one of the reasons why people buy these things in such big quantities. I'm not surprised if you're not looking for, you know, a crossover with any kind of sporting intentions. This is an excellent choice because it is so quiet and so comfortable. That said, there is plenty of body roll. There's a bit of dive under braking, and you know, that's to be expected. These are the standard dampers, not the adaptive dampers that the F-Sport handling package gets. So there is some secondary and tertiary motion after you do hit a bump, and that's okay. It's reasonably well controlled, but again, this is tuned for comfort over handling. I have to say good things about this transmission. It does shift nice and smooth. I can't complain in that regard, although it is often slow to respond. So for example, if you're accelerating onto the highway, and like I'm doing here, I'm following somebody who's going way under the speed limit and I want to get up to speed, well, I step on the gas, one, two, and you know, it's almost a full second before that transmission downshifts a few gears and gets us up to speed. Like the rest of the RX, this transmission is definitely tuned for smooth operation, not instantaneous response, and that's okay because it does suit the character of this RX. Steering is adequate. There's nothing wrong with it at all. It's got more assist than you probably need, and that's okay because, again, it suits the character of this RX. It's not pretending to be sporting in any way. Overall, I guess I understand why people buy these things, because it's so easy to live with and there's nothing wrong with that. No, it has no sporting intentions whatsoever. It is just comfortable and easy to live with, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Not my kind of midsize crossover, but that's okay. There are plenty of choices. Sure, I'd love to see this have a little more sporting characteristic, but there, of course, are some other options from Lexus and Toyota if that's your jam. My verdict, well, I can see why so many people like these Lexus RXs. The attention to detail that Lexus puts into it, it's very easy to live with, but it's exceptionally quiet and very, very comfortable. And I'm sure that's what makes it popular with a lot of people. I don't care for the infotainment system, as I've already mentioned, but otherwise, it's a very easy living crossover, and I understand why lots of people buy these things. It's kind of like listening to the Yacht Rock channel on satellite radio. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2021 Lexus RX 350 Blackline Edition. Hope you like this piece, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, linked below, and we've got lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our popular line of Save the Manuals merch. And who knew that Toyota would be one of the companies that's actually saving the manuals in 2021? Indeed they are. Lexus doesn't have any manuals at the moment, but Toyota does. Gotta love Toyota for that. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even mid-sized luxury crossovers.